benefit. Gonna be a fit. Peace to the world. Let it rotate. Money, DNA.
Yeah. Pulling up with the crew.
Oh my goodness.
Must have done same with the roof.
Oh my goodness.
You sitting looking stupid on the stoop.
Oh my goodness.
I would take notes if I were you.
Oh my goodness.
This was designed with the stars, the square and the cross, so we know truth.
Hello, everybody. I'm Larry Williams.
All right, Larry, thanks. We are across the Hudson from Midtown Manhattan at MetLife Stadium in East Rutherford, New Jersey. Today, we're set for a good AFC matchup between the Pittsburgh Steelers and the New York Jets. First down, Downs to throw, and his first look is incomplete. He was looking for his tight end, Jacob Tammy, there, and it's second down. For Matt Forte. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. So he loses 3 yards there. Now third down.
Came out in a power set. That only served to put more men in the box. And guess what? If you're going to do that, you've got to win up front, right? Your offensive guys have got to beat the defenders. They lost all leverage on that play.
And he motions the wide receiver. From the shotgun, here's Downs, eluding the pressure right. He loses 4, and it brings up 4th. So on 4th down, here's Jake Shum to punt it away. Back deep, Travis Benjamin. They punted 3 times in the loss last week as he sends this one away. And a fair catch called for and made just inside the 35-yard line. So a change of possession here on the punt. And the Jets take possession. This is Lamar Miller. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. It'll be a pickup of 16 and a Jet first down. That O-line, they cleared a big hole there on that run.
The athleticism of offensive lines continues to evolve, and we're seeing it here. Not only are they controlling things right at the line of scrimmage, but they're able to get upfield to get to what we call the second and the third levels. You know, get to the linebacker spot, the secondary spot, getting all the way downfield with their blocking, which helps keep the running back clean.
They'll try to continue that trend here this afternoon. And he's brought down. That's good for a Jet first down, a gain of 13.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field, and now what he's trying to do.
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Ryan Shazier coming on the blitz. He gets him for a loss of 7.
And plays like that really hurt play calling. They had a really nice gain on the previous play, but gave about half the yardage back on the sack. Excellent pressure up front. Nowhere to go with the football. Down he goes.
And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line.
All right, partner, let's go back over the last couple of plays. Sack, loss of yards on a running play. Not exactly the sequence that an offensive coordinator gets comfortable with when calling plays.
Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long. Now Garoppolo. And he's going to be hit and taken down. Back right around the 48-yard line. Bud Dupree in there to get him. And that's sack number 6 for him on the year.
Well, certainly some teams are not intimidated by down and distance on defense, are they? Third and very long? Let's go get this guy again. Big time pressure.
He gets it away, and I think they'll smartly play keep away here from Brown. And a bit of a mistake there. This is well into the end zone for a touchback. Out comes the Steeler offense now, ready to see what they can do here. And to be frank, they're just in a tough spot. It's only November, already eliminated from playoff contention. I know their fan base doesn't want to hear that, but that's the case. What are they fighting for now going forward?
You know exactly what they're fighting for. Is that word that some people don't want to hear, but it's pride.
Draft. Oh, okay. Yeah. I was going to go draft, but pride's better, right?
Well, you know something? You're right, because that's part of it, but that's two different mindsets. That's front office mindset, yep. Draft position, where are we going to be and what do we need to get? And then the players and the coaching staff right now, pride. Can they win some games and feel better about themselves despite the fact they have no shot at the playoffs?
On second down, Dobbs over the middle. Rodgers has it. And down he'll go at the 25. That catch good for 5. It's third down. Yards to gain here on third down.
Here we go.
To throw is Dobbs. Screen pass to Charles. And he's able to get it to the 31, and that's enough for the first. They get 6 on the pickup there as the drive will continue.
Let's give a little credit there. The offensive play caller sensed that the screen pass was available. Whenever you're getting a lot of heavy pressure towards your quarterback, that's when you're thinking about running the screen and using that pressure against the defense.
And all the ball's out. Forte loses it, and it's scooped up by the Jets. And they have the football and will take over at the 24-yard line. That's probably bringing back nightmares of last week, isn't it?
No doubt about it. Right now, I'm looking over at the coaching staff, and I'm seeing the wheels turning in their heads. And you know what is happening? They're remembering how they started the season in camp, even in the offseason where they emphasized ball security, and they're wondering why the message isn't sinking in.
They had 5 turnovers last week, now 1 here in the opening quarter.
Encroachment defense.
A little antsy on the left side of the line.
Yeah, I think they got the guy in the end. I think they got the DN there on that one. And let's face it, he is so amped up, wanting to get a good get off on the snap, jump too quickly.
Let's go! Blue 90! Blue 90!
From the gun, it's Garoppolo. And he's gonna go down. He sacked back at the 24.
The game plan for any defense is finding ways to make a quarterback uncomfortable in the pocket. When you bring pressure from all angles, you never know who's going to get home. In this case, the left cornerback, right in the face of him, puts him down.
On second down, here's Miller. They'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down.
And Cameron Hayward's ability to take on blocks, hold the point of attack, and get upfield serves him very, very well. What a nice play there.
Yeah, he can take on blocks because he's built like a block. And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively.
Watching that, Barney, Barney!
Working from the gun, Garoppolo. Oh, and a Bad throw there. It's intercepted. Picked up by the former first-rounder, Artie Burns. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
And, Brandon, this is a real nice job defensively of getting inside a quarterback's head and figuring out, okay, where's he going with the football? Because you can make an educated guess defensively, not all the time, but sometimes. And when you're right, you've got a decent chance of coming away with the football.
Dobbs looking to throw on first down. Steps away to his left. And he just gets rid of it. Throws it away. The wise move there. Looked like nobody open. Now second down. And this passing game's whole offense really didn't show up in the loss last week, and it hasn't started all that great here either.
Yeah, and they can't let that incompletion become an uh-oh moment. Like, oh boy, here we go again, just like last week. Each game is its own entity, treated as such.
On second down, Forte. And he'll lose yardage and be down at the 7-yard line. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that's going to lead to a 3rd and 11. And the offense there, the O-line, everybody really on offense, they were just manhandled at the point of attack.
Yeah, you could pretty much call them all out, couldn't you? And almost by name, right? That was a very tough sequence for the offensive line. But how about that defensive front creating a new line of scrimmage and creating a lost yardage possibility?
3rd and 11, and some extra depth to the secondary here. They're in the dime. Gun, Dobbs hits his target, Hunter, and he's going to have the first down as he's marked down just shy of the 20.
In today's football, where receivers break tackles, make people miss, get upfield for the extra yardage.
Back with Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin. It's Steeler football to begin quarter number two, and they've got it here with a first down. Going to lose yardage here. Back to his own 18. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Brandon, that play certainly felt like what I call a tendency breaker. 1st and 10, they dial up a draw play. That's not a normal situation, but give credit to the defense. They weren't fooled at all and really finished off the play.
Dobbs now on second down. Flush to his right. Oh, he's got a little daylight. The Steeler first down on the pickup of 11 yards.
That was an excellent job of recognizing the situation. His first read wasn't there. Heck, his second read wasn't there. But he bought himself a little extra time scrambling out of the pocket, got to the sticks, and picked up the first down.
This is Forte. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time and a first down.
Now that's how you start to get back in the good graces of your head coach. Remember, he fumbled on the last possession. How about the faith they showed him, giving him the ball again, and he repaid him, picking up a first down.
Complete. That's Hardy. And into the end zone. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. A big play there with his first career NFL touchdown. And the Steelers are able to strike for 6. So that's the rookie's first trip to the end zone, and I think it's safe to say one he'll always remember.
Oh, without a doubt. That one is going to be imprinted forever. And nowadays, we're seeing rookies make a greater impact at that position at receiver than ever before. I think mainly because of the sheer volume of footballs that they catch in college.
out to kick is Janikowski. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchdown. The New York set to take the field. And this is a unit that, to be frank, doesn't look like they've woken up yet. I mean, a punt and a turnover on their first two drives.
And I think the game's starting to take shape a little bit now. And I'm going to take it into the basketball world. When you're having trouble scoring or moving the ball in basketball, what do they do? Get it to their best player, right? Find a matchup, create it, exploit it, and try and move the football.
It's Miller. And some room to roam now. Quick move by Miller. And he's brought down after a good game. 23 yards on the pickup there and a first.
Well, partner, I have to say they caught him in the right defense there. Nickel set. Fifth defensive back on the field. And they love to run against that because now you typically get a bigger blocker on a smaller defender.
Yeah, because those DB. And now Miller hit and he fumbles. But I think a Jet was able to recover, and they'll keep possession thanks to a heads-up play.
Wow, that ball gets knocked free, but a teammate comes along and scoops it up. It's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home. The next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he takes this up right near the 45-yard line. Able to pick up a healthy chunk of yards, 7-yard gain, but a tough 3rd and 9 upcoming.
And after that type of a run, there's some talking going on down on the field, but it's not trash talking. The guy who just carried the ball, he's going back and telling his offensive line, great job, keep it up, and we'll break that one soon.
And some space here. He's got the first down and more inside the 40. And they're able to convert on 3rd with a solid gain of 23. Play fake here on first down. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Ryan Shazier in there to pick up his 2nd sack now of the afternoon.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line flat out cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
Now flags will come in. I think this one's going to be on the defense for jumping.
Neutral zone infraction, defense.
They'll step off the 5 yards.
Yeah, partner, you know, defensive end, he wants to get into the offensive backfield. He wants that get off to be as fast as possible. A little too quick on that one.
Second down, here's Garoppolo. That's complete over the middle to Anderson. And he's able to get it down to the 25-yard line. It's a pickup of 12, and that'll set up a 3rd down. Boy, the evolution of the game and how these guys in plays like that can get out of the pocket, keep plays alive, it just makes things so much harder for defenses.
It really does, and we're talking about an era in the game where the quarterbacks are the most athletically gifted that we've seen in a bunch. I mean, when you talk about collectively, it's unbelievable. So their ability to move is practiced now. It's not necessarily, oh, he just took off and you guys figure it out. When he takes off, everyone knows where to go now. They know how to run routes, change things, make themselves presentable for the quarterback. That's a lot of time that they put in on it. It's not just your static 1-2-3, this is where the ball goes anymore.
Oh, look at this. A flip to the kicker. He's going to try to run for it. They're not going to get it. They try to move the chains with a surprise, but it's a turnover on downs. They pass up the three, fake it. It doesn't work.
I like the chutzpah there, right? They decided to go ahead and fake it and try and pick up a first down, but how about how they executed defensively and smothered that one? I know back from my time frame, everyone has responsibilities, even rushing on a field goal attempt. You've got the tight end, you've got the wing back, you might have the guy out of the backfield. Well, they executed that well. Yeah. Really stuck to what they needed to do.
It was a block. If they were ready, they got it done. Forte, and not a whole lot doing there as he'll get it up to about the 28-yard line. A gain of three, second down. An update now from Oakland. The Raiders are out to an early lead. Derek Carr with one touchdown pass thus far. 2 minutes to go here in the first half. We'll come back to MetLife Stadium after this short timeout. A reminder that coming up in 2 minutes, we'll check in with Larry Ridley in Orlando with highlights and analysis of this first half of play.
And I'm going to check in with a heater.
I'm going to be right there with you, partner. Again, they run. Again, it's Forte. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. 8 yards on the pick up there, and it moves the sticks. Back to the ground on first. It's Forte. And he'll get this up to about the 40. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down. Forte. And a big tackle there as the defender runs right through him. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs.
At this stage of the game, the run pass numbers are a little bit out of whack because most of the yardage has come through the air. But in a sense, that just sets things up for big runs like that because the defense might be a little bit off balance. He picked up another first down with that run.
Here's Forte. And he's going to be brought down inside the 45 at the 43. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down. A running play now for Forte. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. He lost 2 there, and it's third down.
We all have habits. We can be somewhat predictable, and you know me pretty well on second down and short. What I like to see.
Play action.
Yeah, without a doubt. I thought that was a great spot to call it. Instead, didn't go their way, did it?
No, defense sold out for the run. Worked out well. And now before they run this fourth down play, we're going to get a timeout. As they'll stop the clock with 24 seconds to go in this first half. Here's Jacob Shum now. He'll boot it away from about his 35. What he was hoping for there is this will hit in the end zone for a touchback. Travis Benjamin and the rest of the troops heading back out there now on offense. You better believe that he's well aware he has 0 catches right now, and they're losing, so he's probably a little hungry.
And you know the guys on defense are aware as well, and they're really excited that he has no catches, but they're also worried because a lot of times that's like the ticking time bomb. The longer you hold him down, when he finally explodes, look out.
Yeah, no catches, though, so far in this game. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They're going to try that again. Go play action, hit him over the top.
And he's going to be stopped dead in his tracks. So we've reached half. Well, Larry, I know it's late there in Orlando. This is a school night. Folks eager to get right back to the action here in the third quarter. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. So out now come the Jets. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works. They go again with Powell. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. It's a loss of two, now third down.
And that's another stop for the defense, something we've seen all game long. They have been on fire today. No matter what's called by the offense, they've had an answer for it.
On play action, it's Garoppolo. He's going to air one out. He rifles one that's intercepted. Sean Davis with a pick. And he brings this one back. It's a pick six for a Steeler touchdown. Third down, passing down. They throw the extra defensive back in there for a nickel package, and it worked out.
And it's not anything that you would think is just great strategy. It's just that when you have five defensive backs on the field and an obvious passing down, it's a lot tougher to complete a pass. And on that play, they completed it just to the wrong team, and it cost them 6 points.
And it's good to make it 14-0. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Here comes Jimmy Garoppolo now to lead his offense back out there. Interesting stat line right now. Technically, he's completed four passes, two to his team and then two to the wrong team.
It makes you wonder what he's seeing downfield because he has completed two passes to his own team, but the interceptions are troubling. Is he going through the wrong reads, the wrong progressions? Is he getting fooled by defenses? They've got to figure that out over on the sidelines, working on that Surface Pro to see what they see.
Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven.
I think they want to start getting back into this game. It behooves them to get better on first down.
Yeah, certainly not what they were looking for there out of the opening play of this drive. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage looked defensively. Now contact up front as penalty markers come in. Who is this against?
Encroachment defense.
So 5 yards there as one of the big guys up front moved.
And in a 4-3 front, you've got the two defensive tackles right near the football. I know there's a lot of movement around there, but they're always taught to have one eye on the football. Apparently, that didn't happen.
Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. That one goes for 24 yards.
There are so many things to watch for when you play defense. And reading your keys, you always hear about that, and having your eyes in the right place. Sometimes your eyes can fool you. How about that play action there? That sprang the big guy, didn't it?
Able to dump it over the top to him. Here's Garoppolo on first and 10. And that is caught by Ardarius Stewart. And he's going to get this inside the 30. Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you go lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
He's got his man on the crossing route. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling.
I know I spent a lot of time talking about how tight ends in a lot of cases now are pumped up wide receivers, but they're still big people. He used that frame right there to absorb a really big hit on him and held on to the ball.
Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal.
There you go now. Boom, right.
Garoppolo again. And he's got it. And he's going to take it in for a Jets touchdown. Bilal Powell, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Jets are able to make this a close game again. That's a score you felt they had to have here in the third quarter to get back in this game.
And you know that there's an emphasis on their side. Hey, we know this. We know where we are. But sometimes that binds you up so much that you try too hard, you don't get the score. A perfect combination of urgency, yet relaxed enough to get it done.
Free kick out of bounds. Kicking team.
And that drives coaches insane, doesn't it? When they see that happen, it just doesn't feel right, does it? Plus, you're giving up yardage.
This is Forte, and he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, this is the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
Second down and a little ways to go here, second and 13. Time to his left, and he's got room, and he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. He turned that into a nice gain, gets him 8 yards closer for third down.
And we have to give credit to him for buying time and extending the play, but you know there's some really upset defenders on that one. They thought that they had him. Instead, he was coated in Teflon and got away.
The Steelers on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This is third and 4.
Here we go.
Forced out to his left. That's incomplete, but there is a flag down. So hang on. A big call coming on third down.
Pass interference. Defense.
Trying to defend the out route there. Got the PI call.
And you know what's difficult about that one? Is sometimes you want to make the undercut move and go for the football. And other times just want to hang on the upfield shoulder and make the tackle. I think he got caught in between and created a foul.
Following the penalty, it's Forte. And he gets it down to the 32. See if they stay on the ground for second down. They stay on the ground. Forte again. And after the good gain last play, this time they say, as he's going to be stopped behind the line of scrimmage. It'll be a loss of 1, and that is going to set up a 3rd and 1. Dives to throw. Being chased out left. He may try and run for this. And he'll be out of bounds just inside the 25-yard line. A good decision in the end to pull it and run. Gets him 9 yards and a first.
Well, that's a nice job right there. He's looking downfield, but with no one open, he takes off and tries to run for it. He gets to the sidelines and gets out of bounds with a first down.
Now a run with Forte. And he'll get about five here as he'll take this down inside the 20-yard line.
In my book, that's running the ball well, but with intelligence. How about him keeping the clock moving, staying in bounds?
Yeah, even though it's the third quarter, you're thinking ahead, aren't you? This is where your running game can really help you with a lead in the second half.
I agree totally. It's not just end-of-the-half situations that you worry about the clock. It's throughout the game. And with a lead, stay in bounds. Make them fight harder to try and catch you.
They'll give it up to Forte. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. 7 yards there, good enough to move the sticks.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball and protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. So the run moves the chains, and here we go on first down. Give. This is Forte. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. And give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six. Now I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage. Work on that clock. See if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely. You want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football. Gain some yardage and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you?
Back now here on EA Sports. It's Steeler football, and they have the lead as well as we begin quarter number four.
Here we go. Man 38.
Out of the pistol, Forte. And they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the 10-yard line. So he loses 3 yards there. Now third down.
Obviously, that's some good work there defensively, being able to stop them and bring up a key third down. But if you're on the offensive side of the ball, there's an opportunity, because I know what defensive guys are thinking right now. Just stop them, get to the ball. That means they might not be sound defensively. There could be some opportunities.
And you said key third down. Highlight that word. Put it in bold. Here we go. The Steelers on third down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This is third and 8. Now it's the Chiefs' all-time leading rusher. It's Jamal Charles on the carry. And running room hard to come by here. He gets it down to the 8. Just a yard on the run there. That's going to bring us to a fourth down. So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. This to make it a 2-score game. Play clock winding down. Oh, he left this one out to the right. That's no good. And this score will stay right where it is. And that one, my goodness, that was almost too easy.
Yeah, and you knock up too many attempts shorter than that one. I don't think anyone got a finger on it. That's about as bad a miss as you can have.
Now the Jets offense gets ready to head back on the field. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look close.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went. No adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away. That was a nice pickup. Some chunk yardage there. Some of those big yards downfield with a little bit of rack thrown in there, a little run after catch. And it came on a crossing route. I could just hear one of my friends who won 4 Super Bowls as a quarterback always said the same.
And this will be caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Jets. And he's a little bit on the shorter side as a receiver. Maybe sometimes for the defense, tough to find the little guys, right?
Yeah, sometimes they get lost in the traffic. But usually what it means is that rather than just winning with height or even speed, they use their quickness to find a way to get open.
Well, tall, short, wide, skinny, whatever. There it results in a touchdown. So here comes the kickoff now, all even here in this fourth quarter. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. We saw a number of good games earlier today. This one might top all of those. It's been a dandy as we come up on first and 10. Now Dobbs. Flushed out right. And some room to work. Give him 10 yards there, and about by the nose of the football, he's going to have a first down.
They're throwing it on first down, but no one was open, so he gets flushed out of the pocket, runs towards the sidelines, gets out of bounds with a good gain and a first down.
Here's Dobbs to throw. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Leonard Williams in there to get him, and that's sack number 8 for him on the year. And they weren't in zone coverage. They were in man, and each man did his job.
And that looked like vintage, old-school coverage, didn't it? Man coverage reminded me of an old Raiders team. They had a Hall of Famer at one corner and a Defensive Player of the Year at the other, and they just locked people down.
And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. Give him 9 yards on the second down screen play.
I wonder what was going through his mind when he got the play call. He just got sacked on the previous play. He knows they're coming after him again. A little bit of guts to stand in there, take the hit, and successfully complete the screen pass. Really well done.
Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long.
Here we go. Man, 38.
Back to throw Dobbs. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Sheldon Richardson in there to get him. And that's sack number 6 for him on the year.
You know, on these types of plays, we're always looking to assess blame. Okay, where did it break down? Sometimes it's just a great play.
He's averaging just under 50 yards a punt as he gets this away. And, oh, he is really laid out that time. Knocked flat on his back at the 38-yard line. And New York set to take the field. They had to go a long way on their last drive to score the touchdown. This time, they get at least a little bit more of a cushion in the field position.
I have to think that with this field position, after what they did on the last drive, they might want to take a shot right now and try and cut down the length of the drive.
Green 39!
Now whistles 39. Come in before the snap. Looked like one of the Jets may have moved.
False start, offense.
So that'll back them up 5. Shotgun snap for Garoppolo. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. Robbie Anderson, the man he was looking for. And that'll bring up second down.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really. Garoppolo to throw on second down. And he goes out right around the 39. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
If you're running out route, it's likely you end up near the sideline. And what did we just see there?
Toe tap.
You got it. The benefits of practice. Toe tapping, foot dragging, picking it up, and making sure it was a catch.
One of the bigger plays in the game thus far. The crowd getting into it as we come up on a big third down. To throw, it's Garoppolo. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. The Steelers put a stop to the action with a timeout defensively. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. He steps into this one, and this is a rocket. And he didn't quite have the backspin on that one. It hits at the four and continues into the end zone. It's a touchback. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Looking to find a lane, but he can't. Reined in at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play. It'll be second down.
Well, he was stopped on that play, but he's had plenty of carries all afternoon. Every now and then, the defense is going to win one, but I don't think they'll shy away from handing it to him the rest of the game.
Here we go! Ohio!
Dobbs is throwing. Escaping the pressure right. And I think the ball's out. And this is going to get out of bounds. So they will gain a bit of yardage on the play, actually. And they'll hold on to the football as well.
I don't know about you, but I can hear and feel the sigh of relief all the way up here in our booth.
That was palpable. The sideline, the friend there.
No doubt about it. Ball goes over the sideline, able to retain possession. No turnover. I know his coaches are screaming, just hang on to the ball, man.
Now Dobbs. A bullet throw, but incomplete.
It's a lot of contact going on there, and in the end, unable to keep two hands on the football and bring it into his body.
Everything looked pretty good until the finish. Now here is the punter, Shum, as he sends this one away. Fair catch signaled for and taken just shy of the 30-yard line. So possession goes over here on the punt. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. The New York set to take the field. And they're coming off a three and out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you called before, realize it hasn't worked
so well. Go to something else.
And maybe you try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area. Play action's supposed to be used to slow down pressure, slow down blitzes. In this case, though, if it takes a little too long to develop, you got people right in your face.
And lucky just to get rid of the ball with the arm going forward. Could have been a fumble. And he'll get this up only to about the 33. So it's Jets football as we get you reset here. And they're facing a big third down now in this tie ball game.
All right, here we go.
Now Garoppolo. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. And now with 1:52 to go, we get another pause in the action. A timeout here defensively. Here's Britton Colquitt now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. And this is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. And this one hits at the three and then bounds into the end zone for a touchback. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense. Get a couple of first downs and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. They'll try and start this drive in the air. Steps away to his left. And he'll be out of bounds near the 30. He'll get 10 there all on his own, but it'll be second down.
Well, he did a nice job keeping his eyes downfield, waiting for someone to get open. But once the pressure forced his eyes down to see the rush, it was time to make a break for it.
Second down, Dobbs, eluding the pressure right. 5 yards on the scramble, and that's enough to pick up the first.
Well, he's proven real effective running the football. No one open, don't force it. Just get what you can, and that's what he's done very well in this game.
Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. The shotgun. Here's Dobbs. Dan, nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And the Jets have recovered.
I'm fairly sure that there's no good time to cough up the football. But this couldn't be much worse, could it?
No.
This situation, this yard line. Chance.
They set it on a tee form. They're already in field goal range here late in the fourth now.
Yeah, warm up the kicker and just make sure they take care of the ball now. They've got a chance to put this.
Really nice starting field position here for the offensive unit.
No. Jack Patriot.
This is the running back Powell. And he'll be knocked down sideways, right at the line of scrimmage. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down.
Partner, you've got about 20 coaches on your payroll, but there's 60,000 of them in the stands. I don't think any of them like that play.
And the later we go, it's starting to sound like 100,000 in here. They'll run again. Again, it's Powell. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards, and that'll bring up a third and one.
Look, the first down marker is out there, but sometimes it's hard to find for an offense when they're in a long yardage situation, which usually means throw the football. In this case, they went against the tendency and ran it, and boy, the reward was there. A big, big pickup, and guess what? It's now third and very short in order to try and pick up a first down.
On third down, that's Powell. So on comes the kicker, Cody Parkey, in a big spot. This to take the lead here in the final minute. And Parkey's kick is good. And the sideline celebrates as they have taken the lead in the final minute. All right, so time to reset here. It's a huge kick there, gives them the lead, but they've got to be careful that their celebrations aren't a little too premature.
You're exactly right about that, because there still is time for the other guys to run a few plays and get into field goal position. So this defense is going to need to come up with one final stop if they're going to get out of here with a victory.
And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. They only need a field goal. Obviously, the clock a huge factor. They'll be watching that. What do they need to do here, Charles?
Your sequence of plays has to get you out of bounds. Completions, get out of bounds, gain some yardage. Then when the clock hits 7 seconds or left, now you've got a decision. Are you in field goal range, or is it Hail Mary time? Because from 7 seconds down, you don't want to take a shot that you're going to have another play.
We'll see how they handle it. Flush to his right. That's caught inside the 20. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field.
Illegal forward pass. Offense.
Now that's one they hate. The ball's got to come all the way back.
So that's an explosive play, a really explosive play that gets wiped out, and they have to start over after the penalty.
To throw. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off by Jamal Adams. And the return stops just a few yards shy of midfield. They'll spot the ball at the 47-yard line.
And that one, oh, it's going to hurt big time. You're in the two-minute drill trying to get your guys down the field, and it's looking like they're going to go up just short, as this is definitely not his best throw. And it'll wind up being intercepted.
Charles, I think with his...